Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, kids of all ages. As you can see there in the neighborhood, a couple people out watching, and down there our neighbors are out watching. The lights are on the deck, and it is starting to get a little bit on the dark side. Let's see if the camera on my phone will catch this a little better. It seems to be, but I don't know. I'm recording also on a video recorder, and all I'm seeing right now is just this real bright blob, which you can also see here in the camera. So I don't know what's what. I don't know if that's the moon in the front and the sun in the back. It's hard to tell, but here we are. And we'll see what it does. The eclipse is supposed to happen here in the Cincinnati area in 3:09 p.m. in the afternoon. This is April 8th, 2024. And not the first time I've seen one. Probably will be the last time. And, well, it is what it is. So, let's adjust that a little bit. I think you can see just a little bit better on the video camera now. Seems as the eclipse gets a little bit darker in the full thing, that big white spot starting to diminish a little bit. I'm sitting here on the deck in Mason, Ohio, at our house, and I wasn't going to do this, but I figure why not make a recording of it, and hopefully my family in the Philippines will get a chance to see this, because I know all my friends here in the U.S. are probably watching it, as many as possible can. I know the girls are all at work, so I don't know if they'll get a chance to step out in time to see this or not. So, but it's all over the news, and you know, all the TV stations are recording it, and they're showing pictures of the fighter jets and stuff that are up in space taking pictures, and all this NASA stuff going on. So I'm sure there's a lot of nut jobs out there now going crazy. But it is what it is. I got nothing better to do since I'm retired. After this, I'll go downstairs, work on my train layout a little bit, and have a little bit of fun today. All right. See if we can zoom in here a little bit. No, not too much. I guess I could hold the camera still. It would be nice, wouldn't it? All right. But there you can see I'm recording also with a video recorder. It's just a cheap Chinese Temu thing that I got. Pretty cheap, actually. And you can see on there that I'm getting a little bit of a picture on there, but we'll see how this camera does. And it is starting to get a little bit darker around here. As you can see, I'm sitting under the awning right now. I don't want to get my eyes out in the sun. Probably not real good for glaucoma, if you know what I'm saying. And I don't have any of the solar glasses to put on. be quite honest, it's very boring waiting for this to happen. But like I said, I got nothing better to do. The clouds are kind of neat looking. As it starts getting a little bit darker here. I gotta admit that it's kind of interesting to see how it's getting dark here. And I guess what we will see when the eclipse is complete is it'll be complete darkness for about 4 minutes. As I ramble on, Led Zeppelin, 1970-something. That was a good song. Of course, most of the Led Zeppelin songs were pretty good, but I'll shut up. Okay. And just so you know, I'm doing this live, but I will be posting these videos later on. After this all happens. I was watching on TV and down in, I guess it was New Mexico where it's already happened. They've already seen this. It was kind of neat to be able to see the solar flares coming off the sun from behind the shadows. And then called something like a diamond ring or something like that. That was kind of neat from where the sun first started poking out. So, yeah, again, it's very cool. I feel like I got sunglasses on. I'm gonna swing down so you can see. It's the sensors came on for the lights. You can tell it's getting darker. Okay. Very, very interesting. I'm waiting for the dogs in the neighborhood to start barking or howling or something. Who knows? I'd hate to be in the nurse or a doctor in the emergency rooms right now. I'm almost sure they're going to get some kind of nut jobs in there today. And then when I worked EMS, full moons. They were never good for squad runs and ERs and stuff. People just tend to go really, really stupid here when things like this happen. And it's starting to get really, really dark now. You can see down the neighborhood, it's... And it's a different kind of darkness. It's not a nighttime darkness. It's just really, really, really different. So even though I wasn't really planning on sitting out here today, I'm kind of glad I did. It's starting to look like sunset. You can see the skies where it's still light. It's really, really starting to get dark now. I can see lights down the street. Hard to tell seeing it on the phone. But it is very cool. Very, very cool. I would say back in ancient times, when these things would happen, that the natives would get very, very freaked out by it because they had no clue what was going on back then. Now, what's really kind of cool, if you listen, if I shut up long enough, you can hear the birds starting to chirp and stuff, kind of like they do at nighttime when the sun's going down. So it's really interesting. Okay, now you can see it is really getting dark. Very cool. And the neighborhood's very quiet. Okay, well, and as you can hear, people are starting to scream and hoot and howl. Like I said, people really do get stupid when these things happen. And it seems like it's starting to brighten up. So I guess this thing happened already, and I really didn't catch it much on the cameras or anything. All right. Well, maybe we just didn't get the full eclipse here in Mason, Ohio. But it was pretty close. It got somewhat dark. All right, and yes, it's getting brighter. All right, well, you know what? That's about it. I thought it was gonna be a little bit better than that, but what can I say? It was definitely interesting. I wanna thank everybody for watching. And appreciate you watching, and we'll get these videos posted and see how they turn out on the screen. Again, it's getting brighter again, and what can I say? All right, thanks for watching, everybody. I know it's not a train video, not a vacation video either, but it is what it is, and I appreciate you watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time with the train video. Hopefully we get the trains running pretty good soon, and fix what little bit of problems we have on those upper two loops, and we'll go from there. So thanks for watching, everybody. Have a great night.